I was 9 the first time I killed to defend the pond. Mother always told me, kill or be killed. My entire life is about survival. But is that really living at all?
You're not gonna shoot him, are you?
This is what I do, Lucy. This is how I keep us safe.
After a while, I realized what was really important to me, and my entire life changed forever. Water, water, everywhere, but not a drop to drink.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Hello, and welcome to Reviews with Raleigh. Today's topic, we will be discussing the book Not a Drop to Drink by Mindy McGinnis. The story revolves around a problematic setting, a world with little to no pure water. I know what you're thinking. Water covers 70% of the earth. Why would water shortage be a problem?
The main problem of a story is that the water contains tiny viruses of cholera, so essentially, you're drinking your own death. Cholera causes hypovolemic shock, acidosis, vomiting, diarrhea, and even muscle cramps. Although the death rate is less than 1%, without treatment, it quickly spreads and kills its victim. Cholera is also known as the Blue Death because it can cause the skin to turn blue or purple.
Cures this deadly disease. Her mom taught her how to purify water, and even after her mother's death, she continues to take precaution. However, a new virus has been introduced to the U.S. recently, similar to how cholera affects the characters in Not a Drop to Drink.
The Ebola virus was brought over into the U.S. from an airplane passenger coming home from a trip to Africa. This virus is very deadly and highly contagious, with a fatality rate of 90%. Symptoms of Ebola include fever, severe headache, muscle pain, weakness, diarrhea, vomiting, abdominal pain, unexplained hemorrhage like bleeding or bruising, and possibly bleeding from the eyes, ears, mouth, or nose. Sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean. And this old world is a new world and a bold.